maybe my friends are right, and he's not into me, and he's not into any woman.
What do you mean by that?
I really think that you are gay.
Oh.
Okay, so bad news and worse news, actually, really. We are on part 4 of the 90 Day Fiancé Single Life Tell-All. And it, in fact, looks like there is going to be a part 5 next week. I get my panties in such a wad over these extended tell-alls because they play all the best parts in the previews. And then you wait all week, like, hyping yourself up and gaslighting yourself that there's going to be something explosive and good. And then you're sitting there the whole episode and they give you, like, a 2-minute segment of something you've never heard before. This is exactly my frustration. We start off where we left off with John getting down on his knee. Like, why not leave that as a surprise for us this episode? So we all know getting on his knee leads to a proposal. And surprise, he proposes, and Megan is like, yay, it fits my timeline, bravo. And then the camera pans to Natalie, who is like crying and her makeup's all messed up. And then you think, okay, Natalie's gonna cry, she's nuts. But then it turns to Chantel, who is also crying. So the grouchy old cat lady in me says that producers called the cast before the tell-all and said someone was going to be getting engaged. And this is why Natalie and Chantel are crying. Because I cannot figure out any other reason why. Megan and John aren't like super in love. John seems a little bit pushed into this engagement. It was definitely not a super romantic special engagement.
For you guys, she really, you guys seem like such a good match. She seems so sweet.
We just need to, you know, like everybody, work on some things.
No.
It's always knowing the problem.
Yeah.
As long as you're going to be aware of the situation, then you can fix it.
Yeah.
Let me know in the comments if this is like a crazy idea, because I just do not get why Chantel and Natalie are crying like that. And then Sean asked Patrick if he's happy for them. And of course he's not. He's been such a poo-poo head.
Here to support him any way I can. And sometimes that doesn't mean I say like all the nice things. But at the end of the day, it comes from my heart. So I'm happy for you guys.
But then that sneaky little meatball goes straight backstage, calls Thais on his phone in front of the cameras. And he is like telling her, wow, I can't believe they're rushing into this. She was just an F buddy 9 months ago. What is he thinking? The whole thing is just so off and weird because then you have Veronica rushing up to John being like, oh, yay, congratulations. And he's like, yeah, well, you know, we got a few kinks to work out, but we're going in the right direction.
God bless you.
So if you didn't know that these are two nearly 40-year-old adults getting engaged, you would think two teenagers just asked each other to prom. That's the whole vibe this gives off. So then it's time for Debbie wearing her little goldfish costume to be in the hot seat with her love affair with Ruben the Cuban. But before he comes out, the whole cast kind of gangs up on Debbie about lying about her age on the dating site. So apparently the judge and jury of this tell-all says there's a certain amount of years you can knock off your age, but 10 is just way too much. And I am no fan of Debbie. She irks the crap out of me. But guys lie all the time on dating sites. They lie about their age. They lie about their height. They lie about everything. I think it would be too much if she was doing this super Darcy catfishy photo thing, but it seems like she's using photos that represent who she is, a sassy old lady. So then you're like rubbing your eyes because they brought out Fernanda as their like guest of this episode. Fernanda, do you even remember Fernanda? She was from Mexico. She married Jonathan and like she found panties in his drawer and he was never around for some reason. And she'd be like, Jonathan, Jonathan. And she'd have large drool hanging out from her fang teeth. So yeah, that Fernanda is here and she's chiming in on Debbie's hot mess. Then Grandma Debbie, Colts Debbie, is like, I think you should be proud of your age. Think about all the people that don't even make it to 68. I'm 72. And as these two Grandma Debbies are going to town over their ages, Tim is sitting over there in his little rhinestone sneakers smirking his ass off. Like, Tim, no, you don't get the right to smirk your ass off when you're wearing those sneakers. So next comes out from backstage Julian, which is Debbie's son, the cop, to poo-poo on her parade. And Julian is always so damn thirsty, but he is thirsty as ever here. He is still leaning into the role where he is the cop protecting his kooky mom. And then comes out Ruben Z. Cuban, and he is wearing his best pimp uniform. And when I say he went all out for the tell-all, it is not an understatement. So his shirt is like a Picasso painting printed on silk. Then he's got a silk jacket over it with all these rainbow colors, magenta silk pants, and his hat is like a groovy lava print that's supposed to be like 1970s, but you can tell he really got it at Spencer's in like 2001. Then Debbie is like, I can live with the pants, but he's a little over the top. He needs to tone it down. And then, like it or not, Ruben Z. Cuban peels off his magenta silk pants, and he is wearing underwear with Debbie's face all over it, and his socks match.
Oh my gosh! Oh my god! Wearing your face on his bloomers.
No.
Is that Debbie on your panties?
Oh my god! That's actually really cute.
And Debbie's like, well, that's very creative. But then she's like, but he didn't want to meet with me when I was in town. And Ruben's like, whoa, whoa, I was going slow to treat you with respect so you wouldn't think I was just trying to jump into your granny panties.
No, no.
I mean, look at him, Debbie. The answer's no.
So Ruben Z. Cuban passes his test with flying rainbow colors because him and Debbie are walking out of this tell-all an official couple now. So then we circle back to Louisa and Tim. I'm so confused as what went down between Tim and Louisa, because Louisa comes out like a scorned, bitter ex-wife. She is throwing down. She's even crying. And Tim's whole story is that they were dating, but it never really progressed really far. He wasn't open and ready, and they just didn't mesh. Louisa's reactions to him not wanting to date her are so over the top. So then Louisa is like, all my friends were right. You must just be gay because that's why you don't want to be with me.
I really think that you are gay.
Oh, is it? I don't think he is gay.
I don't give a what people say.
I really don't like Tim. He irks my soul. And I really wanted to like Louisa, but this whole thing is just getting yucky. And then Goldfish Debbie jumps in and she's like, hey, Tim, have you had your testosterone checked recently? You could be low in testosterone, and that's why you don't want to boom boom Louisa. She's gorgeous. And then to back up Goldfish Debbie, Boston John is like, yeah, I take a shot for that. It's no big deal. And then Tim, sitting on the couch with his eyes rolling back in his head like usual, was like, yeah, maybe I should go get my testosterone checked. Then the whole cast goes backstage, and this feels exactly like last time with Jasmine suddenly having a bag full of another woman's underwear. This next scene seems totally staged for fake tell-all drama.
Jamal and Louisa are pretty close.
So Louisa and Jamal are in a room chatting, and Veronica just happens to be standing there out of ear distance. So the producers want us to believe that Louisa and Jamal did the boom boom, which they probably did. I do not know. They seem to really be attracted to each other. But they are talking about something they did last night, and they did it over and over, and she left his room. It's clearly like they did shots or something. It's not explicitly about doing the boom boom. And then we cut to another scene where Jamal and Veronica have suddenly made up and agree to meet each other tonight after the tell-all. So we leave this tell-all with this circumstance. We are supposed to believe that Jamal and Louisa did the boom boom the night before, like 5 times, and that Jamal plans on leaving this tell-all tonight with Veronica to go do the boom boom with her. Guess we'll just have to see next week on the 5th part of this never-ending tell-all who Jamal did the boom boom with and how many times.